focus on, look at all the stuff these guys are able to do. They had this agenda. It was called 6 in 06, and Nancy Pelosi said within 100 hours we're going to pass all 6 of these initiatives.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's fast forward a couple of months. How are they doing so far?
Well, I'm looking at my list of 1 through 6, and
okay,
I don't see any check marks by any of the numbers. Do you see any, Steve?
No, mine's also
Wait, is this the official tabulation?
This is the official tabulation. This is how they work on Capitol Hill, right?
Right. They started out with the minimum wage, which each house passed, but they can't agree on what that's
going to be. Stem cell funding with federal money.
Stem cell funding, forget it.
The 9/11 Commission recommendations, Medicare adjustments. They also
minimum wage.
Up to $725, student loan bill, which has a lot of support. Why hasn't that done anything? And what about those big oil rollbacks?
Yeah, what about Iraq?
What about all that stuff?
Well, that's what they've been talking about instead.
And they still can't agree.
No, but it's just been a lot of blather about that. It's interesting because I remember discussing these 6 things and saying, you know, most of them were not partisan. In other words, they felt that they could all come together and pass these things pretty quickly in the 100 hours that Pelosi talked about. But so far, they're 0 for 6. It's a stalled agenda. And many people are arguing this is because they spent all their time arguing about these resolutions on Iraq, which have gone nowhere as well.
Well, that's going to be debated very shortly. And just to remind everyone, the president requested $101 billion. The Democrats have upped that to $125 billion. They've added $24 billion worth of pork to the president's request to continue to fund the troops in Iraq. Pork intended to pry loose Democrats and Republicans who would never vote for the strings that they want to put on that 101.
So is it really pork that they're putting into it? It usually pork is something you take home to the people, but instead it's like it's a little, hey, if you vote our way, here's a little cash, because I understand something like $400 million going to some rural student initiative or
something
like that.
In Oregon, they're actually paying for a whole county school district out of federal tax dollars.
What does that have to do with the war in Iraq?
Nothing. Nothing.
But it's going to get that guy to vote yes?
Absolutely. Yes. Otherwise, he wouldn't, and otherwise the resolution might fail.
But here's the other thing going on behind the scenes. You have Steny Hoyer, the House Majority Leader of Maryland, last week sort of grumbling over what he called a slowdown in the Senate. Remember, he's in the House. Then you have Majority Leader Harry Reid of the same political party saying, well, Steny's my friend. He hasn't spent much time in the Senate. In other words, now the fingers are pointing at one another of the same party saying, hey, it's not us delaying anything getting done. It's the other people.
They bit off so much more than they could chew. They promised to do so much in the first 100 hours. Remember, she kept stopping the clock. Well, the clock is not running on a Thursday because we're still celebrating the fact that we're controlling the House of Representatives.
And the House went really fast, but here's what happens. Suddenly it gets into the lap of the Senate and it's like, whoa, we're on a whole different calendar over here. Harry Reid said, quote, I think we've done really, really well. And remember, Harry Reid only controls 51 members. The magic number is 60 to get all that other stuff.